Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time tuning in, my name is Angel Merino, also known as Mac Daddy. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to achieve this look. To be honest with you, I didn't really know where the look was headed. I was just gonna kind of feel it out, and once I started to dip into this eyeshadow palette, which I used for my look today, which is the Perception palette, MakeupShayla, Colourpop, I just kind of got a little creative, and this is what I came up with. So if you guys wanna know how to achieve this look, then keep on watching. So before we get started with the skin, I'm gonna use this Wonder Beauty Beach Balm in Siesta, and this is just super, super hydrating and moisturizing. I just like to apply something on my lips before I actually start the process so that by the time I get to the lips, they're nice and hydrated. So to prep my skin, I'm gonna start with this NARS Luminous Moisture Cream. I've been using this moisturizer as of lately and I love how intense it is in hydration. Just gonna take a little on my finger and then just start to blend it onto my skin. It just feels so rich and hydrating on my skin. I teeter-totter between this one and the Aqua Gel Luminous Moisturizer. They're both equally as hydrating. It just kind of depends how my skin is, to be honest. As of lately, my skin's been a little bit more dry. I've been traveling a lot, so when my skin's a little bit more drier, I tend to use the moisture cream. My skin has been trying to play me lately. I've had a couple of breakouts, as you guys can see. I really don't know what it is, but my skin needs to get it together. For my under eyes, I'm gonna use this NARS Total Replenishing Eye Cream. I love this so much because it just really helps to hydrate underneath my eye area so that when I apply my concealer, there's no creasing. And I like to just smooth it out with my finger and almost lightly just kind of tap and press around my eye. For my skin today, I'm gonna be using this Lancome Skin Feels Good Moisture Tint. Now, this is technically supposed to be like a tinted moisturizer, which I'm normally not a big fan of, but as of lately, I've been so obsessed with this formula. It looks so beautiful and dewy on the skin. And as far as the coverage goes, I find that it's actually very, very, very buildable. So I just like to apply it with a beauty blender until I layer it enough to where my skin looks flawless and I feel comfortable. So I typically start off with that moisture skin tint, and then to build a little extra coverage, I like to layer something else on. For today, I'm gonna be using this Lancome, I hope I'm saying it right, Teint Idole Ultra Makeup Stick, and I'm using the shade 450 Suede. Now I do love foundation sticks. I love any foundations that are nice and creamy. This is just a little easier because I can just literally just kind of like glide it on my cheeks. Now it is a little bit more tan than my complexion, which I don't mind. I just kind of mainly go in this area where I shave because that's where you can kind of see through a little bit more, and then I just blend it out with my beauty blender. So now that I feel comfortable with the amount of coverage on my skin, I'm gonna move on to a little concealing and highlighting. I have been so obsessed with this KKW concealer. This is shade 5. I'm kind of shook because you guys know that I love shape tape, and as of lately, this has totally been replacing my shape tape. So I'm gonna use this today. I normally feel like I have to conceal and then I have to highlight, but I just find that this shade 5 just kind of does it for me. So I'm not having to necessarily conceal anymore. I just kind of go straight on with this shade 5 and blend it out, and I feel really comfortable with how my under eyes look. Just by where I place it, you guys can kind of see where more or less I like more of my brightness. It's typically more in the center of my face. That's where I kind of like more of the lightness and the brightness to be. And then I just take like the opposite end of my beauty blender and I just stipple and blend out. This formula is really nice and creamy, and when I tell you guys, like, she's a lot of coverage, she's a lot of coverage. So now that I've blended out my concealer with my beauty blender, I'm gonna go in with this Pure Cosmetics foundation stick. This is in the shade Warm Tan, and I'm just gonna use this to contour my cheeks a little bit and just kind of start to bring some warmth and definition to my face. I'm just gonna take the bottom of my beauty blender to stipple this out. So now that I've blended that out, you guys can kind of see that it's starting to come together and we're starting to see a lot more definition, a lot more kind of structure to my face. Now I'm going to set my under eyes using this Pure Cosmetics Translucent Powder. It doesn't have a shade, it's just the translucent loose setting powder. It has a really interesting applicator because you open it and you can go straight on from the powder puff, but I just like to work from the inside with a brush. So I'm gonna grab a kind of like fluffier stippling brush. I'm gonna pick some of that up and just kind of start to press it underneath my eyes to set my concealer. I've noticed that this powder is really smooth and it looks nice and smooth underneath the eye area. It's not too heavy and cakey looking like other translucent powders can be, so it just gives a really nice airbrush finish under the eyes. So I'm basically using this powder to set all of the areas where I applied that KKW concealer. So moving on to bronzer, I'm gonna be using this Elcie Cosmetics bronzer in light. I'm obsessed with this formula. It's so creamy and smooth and it blends out so beautifully. I got a new one because I literally hit pan on the last one that I had, and I'm just gonna be using this bronzer brush from Sonia Kashuk to apply it on my skin. It basically, I'm just taking this bronzer and I'm lightly buffing it over the areas that I applied that cream contour just to set it and add a little more definition. I actually like to tap my bronzer on my forehead to kind of almost set that cream contour, but it also kind of kicks up that definition. I'm also going to take a little bit of that Elcie bronzer with a pencil brush just to contour and define my nose. To create a little more definition to my cheeks, I'm gonna use my Beauty Blender to pick up some of that translucent powder, and I'm lightly just going to press this underneath my contour just to almost clean up and define a little bit more. And before I move on to my eyes, I'm gonna use a little bit of this translucent powder just to lightly bake underneath my eyes to catch any fallout in case there's any while I'm doing my eye makeup. So at this point, you might be looking a little crazy, but it's okay, because we are just gonna let this bake a little, and then before we are done, we're going to dust it off. I'm gonna start off with my brows. I'm gonna be using this NYX Cosmetics Precision Brow Pencil. This is in the shade Charcol. I'm gonna start off with the spoolie side just to kind of lightly just brush through my brows and make sure they're nice and combed. Ooh, what the hell is that? Don't know what that is, okay. So we're just gonna comb through just very, very, very lightly. I'm gonna start off with a little bit of brow powder. I'm gonna be using this Benefit Cosmetics Foolproof Brow Powder in the shade number 5. And I'm just gonna take an angle brush just to start applying a little bit of this to my brows. And now to really kick up my brows, I'm gonna be using that NYX Brow Pencil. And I like to just use it towards that tail end of my brows just to lightly extend them a little bit more. You see how it just gives it a little, it just makes a tiny little difference, but I totally see it. So moving on to my eyes, I'm gonna prime them using this Covergirl Lid Lockup Eyeshadow Primer. I'll apply it from the wand, but then I actually like to use my finger to blend it out. So now that my eyelids are nice and primed, I'm gonna go in with this Perception Eyeshadow Palette. This is in collaboration with MakeupShayla and Colourpop. I've been using this eyeshadow palette and it is so amazing, blends out so beautifully, and the looks that you can create, the range of looks is amazing. So I'm gonna use these shades to start to warm up my crease. I'm gonna start off with this shade called Culture. So now I'm going to go in with this shade named Revenge and a smaller blending brush. I'm just gonna add this in my crease. I really love how pigmented these eyeshadows are. There's times where I feel like I have to keep going back into the pan to really get good color payoff, but these literally, like, I pick it up one time and it's enough for me to feel like I got the job done. So I really love how bricky this shade is, because in the pan, it doesn't look like it's gonna be this bricky and red, but contrasted with that color Culture, I really love how it looks. I was actually gonna do a different look, but now that I have this on, kind of inspired me to kind of take it somewhere else. So on my lids, I'm gonna be using this shade Strut and Slay. I'm gonna actually spray my brush with a little Fix Plus and I'm just gonna press it all over my eyes. I'm obsessed with this color. Shayla, you did that with Strut and Slay. I don't think I've ever used a tone like this. It's almost like a pink, but it almost looks a little orange. Like, I'm shook. So now I'm going to take a pencil brush and dip into that shade Revenge again and just run it under my eyes. So to line my eyes, I'm gonna use one of my favorites. This is actually a cream eyeshadow crayon from Jouer. This is in the shade Baroque. Now this shade and this product, you can actually use it all over your eyelids, but I really love using it in my waterline. I think it's a really great way to add some definition without it being too dark and overpowering. It literally is like the most perfect, beautiful, bronze looking shade, and I just love what it does to my eyes. So now that my eyes are done, I'm just going to dust off all of this setting powder. There actually was not a lot of fallout, so that's always a great thing. I am gonna apply my eyelashes off of camera and I will be right back. So I got my lashes on. I am wearing Lily Lashes in the style Mykonos. I'm gonna do a little bit of mascara. I'm gonna be using this Covergirl Flourish Lash Blast Mascara. And I'm just going to use this to kind of bind my natural lashes with the falsies. Just giving it a little wiggle. Pick a little bit more up and also apply this on my bottom lashes. So before I apply my highlight, I'm going to spritz my face with this brand new MAC Cosmetics Fix Plus in Gold Light. I don't know why that was such a mouthful. It's the most beautiful thing when you shake it. It looks so stunning. I'm gonna give my face a few spritzies. And by few, I mean a lot. For my highlighter today, I'm gonna be using this Lancome Dual Finish Highlighter in the shade Luminous Gold. This is such a beautiful shade. It literally is like so pretty. And I'm just going to use a fluffy brush. Just gonna dust it on my cheeks. Also going to add a little on the temples of my forehead. This is a really, really gold highlighter, you guys. It's definitely gold. If you want that like true 24 karat gold magic, this baby right here will give it to you. Give me a little moment in here. I'm also gonna take a little tiny bit and apply it on my nose. So to complete my look, I am moving on to my lips. I'm gonna be using this NARS Power Matte Lip Pigment Lipstick. It's a lot bigger than this. This is just the travel size that I have. This is in the shade American Woman. I think this has to be one of my favorite liquid lip formulas because it is so, so, so smooth and creamy. It literally doesn't feel like anything on your lips. And it dries really fast, which is always nice. I'm just gonna just go at it. I normally don't do too much color on my lips, but I thought that this looked really pretty contrasting with the eye makeup. So I'm just gonna let this set and then we're gonna apply a little bit of gloss. And to top my lips off, I'm gonna be using this ultra glossy lip, literally in person, like the pearls in this, I can't even describe it. It's like a hot pink and a gold, it looks so stunning. This is the shade Neat Freak. I personally love the ultra glossy formulas from Colourpop because they feel really nice and smooth. They're not sticky at all. So this is just gonna give my lips a nice, beautiful shine, but it's always gonna be comfortable and super wearable. And lastly, just gonna set my makeup one more time with this MAC Fix Plus in Gold Light. Just gonna give it a little shake, shake, shake. Alright guys, and that pretty much completes this makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and you learned a thing or two. Definitely, definitely, definitely get your hands on this MakeupShayla and ColourPop Perception Palette because it is definitely popping and you need this in your life. I'm really happy with how this came out. Like I said, I normally don't do too much color on my lips, but I thought that this was a really pretty kind of combo with the eyes, and overall I'm really happy with how this looks. If you guys liked this look, give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below what you guys want to see next and what you thought of this look. And before you go, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you guys know every time I upload a new video. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and all that jazz, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.